Well, Health and Human Services hopes to be wrapping up the testing very soon. However, they say depending on the results that have yet to come in, there's always the possibility that they may have to expand the testing even further.
27 people have now tested positive for the same strand of hepatitis C. The virus attacks the liver. All but one were patients of Exeter Hospital's cardiac cath lab. The remaining person was an employee. Health officials continue to say it's likely that a drug-addicted staff member using needles may have been the source. They still have 110 people to test and 65 results pending. Right now, they recommend that anyone who visited the lab from October 2010 until May of this year be tested.
Our rule to decide what patient to test is basically taking the first procedure date that we know transmission occurred and take 6 months back and test all the people 6 months back. Then we find a new case that was earlier, we take 6 months back from that.
During the testing, officials also got 12 other positive hepatitis C results. While they're not connected to this outbreak, they are being closely looked at.
Based on what we know so far from the CDC, they're all separately different viruses. They're not connected to one another.
With fear and anxiety rising, numerous people have sought legal action. Attorney Mark Abramson in Manchester says he has now filed lawsuits for 10 patients who have all tested positive for hepatitis C. And attorney Peter McGrath in Concord has 70-plus people signed on to a class action lawsuit. Dr. Elroy Price says she can understand patients' frustration and says the number of positive cases is disturbing.
It is a large number, and it's very unfortunate. All of those people are people who have could have chronic infection for the rest of their lives, and it's very sad. It shouldn't have happened.
Now, the U.S. Attorney's Office as well as the Attorney General's Office are investigating this outbreak, but right now they have no new information to release. Reporting live in the newsroom, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.